let's get to the news. Well, last night was the closing ceremony for the 2020 Tokyo Olympics, which, because of COVID, were actually held in 2021, which means it's only 3 more years until the 2024 Olympics are postponed to 2027. The 2020 Tokyo Olympics ended yesterday, and U.S. athletes brought home 39 gold medals, 41 silvers, 33 bronze, and 4 new variants. President Biden on Saturday held a Zoom call with Team USA Olympians, and if you thought winning a gold medal was tough, try explaining to a 78-year-old man that he's muted. No, Mr. President, I know you can hear me. I can't hear you. The United Nations today released a new report on climate change, and I don't want to say it's bad, but this was the cover. President Biden announced a new goal last week that half of all vehicles sold in the country by 2030 should be electric, and for some reason, the other half should be vintage Stingrays. Everything's heating up, so you gotta keep it cool. The Rolling Stones recently announced they'll go back on tour in September after it was put on hold last year due to the pandemic. It's actually the second time it's happened to them. Disney World last week unveiled designs for its new Star Wars-themed hotel that will open next year and feature an immersive experience. Though if you're a fan of Disney and Star Wars, the only thing you haven't been immersed in is society. The makers of Crocs recently filed lawsuits against Walmart and nearly 20 other companies that claims they copied their popular shoe style. Said Walmart, "That's a pasta strainer." And finally, the ice cream company Marble Slab recently announced a new collaboration with Frito-Lay to create a Hot Cheetos-flavored ice cream. Well, technically, it was also a collaboration with weed. New York Governor Andrew Cuomo announced today that he will resign amid multiple allegations of sexual harassment. And this is frankly amazing. He made the announcement via book. That's right, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo announced today that he will resign amid multiple allegations of sexual harassment. So tune in to CNN tonight for, I don't know, a rerun of the history of the sitcom? Cuomo resigned today after being accused of sexual harassment by at least 11 women, and that's not even including the time he sexually harassed all of us.
Seth.
Yes.
I came here today to hang out.
Yeah.
And I love your monologues.
Thank you. But
can't we just have a conversation about the news?
Sure.
Can't we just be, like, European?
Right.
You know what I mean? Because in France, they, like, discuss things.
Oh, I see. So you sort of feel like the American way of talking about the news is, like, joke, joke, joke. But you want to
slow it down. It's very, like, you know, toxic masculine. You know what I mean?
Oh, right.
But let's just discuss what's going on. Hi, everybody.
Amy Poehler, everyone.
Hi.
Well,
I'm in New York for the summer. I love seeing you always, and I only get to see you often when we're working together or when I'm doing your show. So, like, let's hang out. Let's take this time.
Well, you're in New York, and, you know, I knew you were coming today, but I didn't know we would have Governor Cuomo resign this afternoon.
Yeah, Cuomo go-go's.
Cuomo go-go.
He went.
I want to run by some of the ways he says he greets people.
Ooh.
And I want you to tick. There were 4 he mentioned.
Okay.
I want you to tick if it's okay or if it crosses the line for you.
Okay.
Grip of the arm.
I don't like the word grip.
Yeah, grips are problematic.
That makes me nervous.
Yeah. I think, yeah.
Especially, I bruise easily, too. So a grip is going to give me a bruise.
Yeah.
And I don't want to remember that I met you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to say no to that.
Pat on the face.
I don't like the word pat either.
No. I don't like anybody touching my face.
You're very particular about your
face. Inside of the mouth is fine, because that's the... I don't like the dry side,
mm-hmm.
but the wet part.
Yep. The only person allowed to pat my face is my plastic surgeon.
At the end, to see if it holds, if it's holding.
Good job. Sticks it together.
I think we're good. He's like, I'm going to give it a few pats, and then if it holds, you can go right out.
He's like, here we go. It won't fall off.
Slap on the back.
Well... I have a more positive connotation with that because that feels Irish to me.
Right.
But in this case, it's Italian.
Yeah. I think of everything we've gone through so far, slap on the back is the finest.
Although we've all had experiences where we've gotten the, like, angry slap on the back.
Right.
From somebody that's like, good job, buddy.
Passive aggressive.
Yeah.
Where you, yeah. So here's the one that He buried this one. This was the third one he said, because this was the
he
one
mumbled
that he
this
got. Well, this is the one that he was sort of, he was referring to this allegation. Touch of the belly.
That's going to be a no for me.
That's a no, yeah. And that was...
That's going to be a no for
a
me.
A no for me. And he touched a woman's belly.
Okay, yeah. Bellies, any lady will tell you, a belly is, you don't, that's not, unless you're very proud of your abs.
Right. I, as a man, I don't like my belly touched, and I've got like a 50-pack, you know.
You do.
It looks like bubble wrap.
Well, it looks like a plastic bag filled with 50 beers.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But beer cans.
Beer cans, like that shape. Yeah, belly. You know, when you're a woman, when you're a pregnant woman, that is a big thing.
He maybe said stomach. I'm now realizing.
Okay, because belly's very different than stomach.
Yeah, I don't want to, like, the guy's had a bad enough day.
Okay, but stomach.
It's the same part, but he did say stomach.
Touch
a stomach.
Yeah, it's going to be, again, like, stomach is a very forbidden place. Like, few people touch other people's stomachs.
Yeah.
Unless you're pregnant, and then everyone on the subway.
Right.
Touches you on the stomach.
You're right. You were New York pregnant.
I was New York pregnant, and people really come at you like, they really want to get it. They really want to get it.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you this.
Yeah.
Which is a nice thing that I hope happens in the future. I would really like, we're going to have a new mayor. We're going to have a new governor. I really want them to get along. There were a lot of problems I had with the leadership of the city and the state, but it really bothered me that the governor and the mayor didn't get along.
Yeah, I mean, and they can get along New York style.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, like, tease each other.
Yeah,
you
know, along Lethal Weapon style, where it's like, you're two different people.
Exactly.
They were buddy cops in the first act of a buddy cop movie who just never went to the second or third act.
You're right. Like, it is, when you have stress in life, and a lot of families have a lot of stress right now, you don't want to also see your politicians arguing like that.
And
that's
really
true. That's very true.
I don't think they liked each other at all.
No, they didn't like each other at all.
I think de Blasio's super happy today, in a way that's maybe a little... I think he should try to tamp it down a little.
He's probably given a lot of slaps on the back.
Yeah.
And he's like, sorry to hear about this, buddy.
He's like, give me a, I'm gonna touch some stomachs.
He's like, let me see your stomach. Oh!
The Senate yesterday passed the $1 trillion bipartisan infrastructure bill. It's what Chris Cuomo is calling absolutely the only news right now. That's right. The Senate yesterday passed the $1 trillion bipartisan infrastructure bill, and 19 Republican senators voted for the legislation, including Minority Leader Mitch McConnell, which means that, oh, no. Oh, what's wrong with it? What did we do? When asked during a press conference yesterday to assess New York Governor Andrew Cuomo's time in office, President Biden said, quote, he's done a hell of a job. No offense, but I don't think that's what they were asking about. If someone asked your opinion on what O.J. Simpson did, they don't mean with the Buffalo Bills. Former Education Secretary Betsy DeVos announced yesterday she will not run for governor of Michigan next year. Well, actually, she said president of Michigan, but you get the idea. The state of Oregon today restored its statewide mask mandate after receiving this dire warning. A driver in Staten Island this weekend crashed into the front of a Dunkin' Donuts. Oh, man, that was like their one nice restaurant. Sorry, Colin. Sorry, Pete. And finally, Pepsi announced a new partnership yesterday with the brewers of Sam Adams Beer to create an alcoholic version of Mountain Dew. And if that sounds good to you, don't worry about what's in the vaccine. Incoming New York Governor Kathy Hochul appeared this morning on the Today Show, and so did Cuomo. The White House announced yesterday that the Biden administration will send more than 800,000 doses of the Pfizer coronavirus vaccine to Caribbean countries. Not on purpose. Ron DeSantis just keeps chucking them into the ocean. Officials in Philadelphia announced a new mask mandate yesterday due to rising coronavirus cases, which is going to be tricky for any Philly residents who have no discernible mouth and only one huge nostril. Amazon opened a new billion-dollar air hub in Kentucky yesterday that will serve as the central location for Amazon Air. Coincidentally, Amazon Air is also what makes up most of their packages. In a new interview, Rudy Giuliani said that disgraced New York Governor Andrew Cuomo will, quote, resurrect himself in some way. And I'd take Rudy's word for it because it looks like he was just resurrected. Rock band Maroon 5 announced yesterday that attendees of their upcoming Ohio concert must show proof of vaccination or a recent negative coronavirus test because they need to make sure nothing bad happens to Maroon 4. I mean, they're not for everyone, but some people love Maroon 3 and want to keep them safe. There's just something special about Maroon 2. Oh, my God, run at them! Today was National Middle Child Day, but don't worry if you forgot. Everyone did. Astronauts aboard the International Space Station recently held their own version of the Olympics, and it really spooked the dressage horse. And finally, as the U.S. continues to fight the outbreak of the Delta variant, doctors are now raising the alarm over yet another strain of coronavirus spreading across the country, the Lambda variant. So what exactly do we know about Lambda, and will it be as dangerous as Delta? Let's find out now in a segment called Getting to Know the Lambda Variant. Was first identified in Peru in August of 2020. Has officially been classified by the WHO as a global variant of interest. Is definitely a virus, and not that new John Grisham novel your dad is reading. Originally rushed Delta, but didn't get in. We'll be in Provincetown on Labor Day weekend if you want to go in on an Airbnb together. This was the sound the space dressage horse danced to. Already visited Brazil, Colombia, Ecuador, France, Spain, Chile, Argentina, the UK, and Canada, and it's only halfway through its gap year. Says the Johnson & Johnson vaccine tickles. Is considered a cousin to the Alpha variant, so don't tell anyone they kissed that one time at a family reunion. Just RSVP'd yes to 3,000 August weddings. Already an early favorite for Governor DeSantis's VP if he runs for president in 2024. Just got cast in the next three seasons of Grey's Anatomy. And finally said it would F Moderna, marry Pfizer, and kill unvaccinated people. This has been Getting to Know the Lambda variant.